So access modifiers are the keyword or modifiers, right? So they are using as a keyword, as a prefix of the component, and this will control the accessing of the members and component of the program, or accessing the member of the class, right? So there are three types of access modifier here, right? One is a private, protected, and public. This is a major reason to say that Java is secure one, right? So because of you can control the accessibility of the any component of the program or class or object by the help of the private, protected, and public. So what is a private, right? So if the any variable or data members and functions is declared as a private, then what is sense that? So only those data members within the same class can be accessed those members, right? So if any members are declared as a private, then so in the same class you can access the, in a same class any member functions you can access, right? So simple and the protected means if the any member of the class is declared as a protected, those members can be accessed by the class itself, means where it is declared, and members of the class itself where it is declared, and members of the subclass, means what if we have one class, so where we have defined the protected data members, from that class another class is declared, right? That class is inherited from the base class. Now those protected member can be accessed by the subclass. Simply the members are accessed by subclass and same class. And public is if you are declared any member functions or member data members as a public, so now this member can be accessed by, that member can be accessed by out of the class. So you can access by within a class or class members, and you can access by inherited class, you can access by out of the class, totally inherited class, right? You can apply the same access modifier to the class also, right? If any class is declared as a private, then the class cannot be created or accessed by the out of that, means so you cannot create object outside of that. And if it is a protected, means you can create an object in the same package or what. And public, it's completely accessible in a complete package, right? That is called as public. And these are three access modifier we are using, that private and protected and public. And then we will move to the what is a IO in Java, right? So here there are three major streams you need to understand for the IO. One is system dot in and system dot out and system dot error. These are three inputs, IO streams in a system class, or sometimes called as files also, right? A system dot in is a input stream. You can create, you can get input data from here, from this file, or else it is an input stream, right? It will generate one stream, such that it will store the input from the what, from the keyboard or some other input device, and store it in a file. And the system dot out stream is a just stream to output the data or sequence of data in on screen. And error, it is an error stream. If something error occurred in a IO operation, that is a system error stream. And there are so many features in Java to perform the IO operations. But here I am going to cover in that what are the input output operations I have used, and what are the class I have used for the IO operations, right? And first I will go to input. So input is nothing but you are reading some data, right? If something, any program is there, any algorithm is there, right? We have to give the input to the system, and it has to execute and it has to generate the output. To give the input, right? So we are giving through the keyboard, right? So we are using here two classes. By the help of two classes, I am all the experiment are executing input operations. Scanner class, and another is by using class that is buffer reader class. So these are the input classes. This class present in Java dot util class, and this present in package Java dot io package. And when you are performing IO, right, in a Java IO operations, right, scanner, why you need to use that? Scanner class is a final class, right? What do you mean by final class? Means you cannot create any instance for that class, right? So if you create the final class, which is a final, right? Sorry, you can create a instance for that. It's a, you cannot modify that class, or you cannot override any functions of that class. So scanner is a one class, final class which is present in java.util, right? From this, what it will do that, it will provide some functions to read the data as a tokens, right? That is a major advantage of the scanner class. So whenever you are using reading that data as a tokens, right, no space, no tabs, then it is better to go for the scanner class. And it is used to read the, right, read as tokens, and it is also used, have a features to read the primitive data types. What are the primitive data types, right? Like example, you can read the integer, you can read the float, you can read the, no need to convert again externally, right? So there are some input, it will read the as a string, and you have to convert into, you have some classes to convert the string to integer and integers to, that is, you can say that caching, but the scanner is a, it has inbuilt functions. Those functions provide that, so read the primitive data type. Like example, so next is a one function which reads the input data as a tokens, string, just is reading the string token. And you can write next int. This function is used to read the next integer as a token. And same float, sharp. So I'm suggesting here that, so if you are using to read the, you are reading that any tokens, or else you are reading the name without space, then you can go for the scan. And now the question is, if I want to read that input with the stream, right, or as buffer, you need continuous characters, then what is the better? So it doesn't mean that scanner cannot support that, we have, it can support, but we have to, it will become a complex mode again. A buffer reader is a one class, so it is used to read from the buffer. Buffer reader function, class, allow you to read from the buffer. So you can read from the buffer, like read line, read complete text, or read some characters array, or else read the complete buffer size. Right, that is a feature of buffer readers are having. How to do that? First, you have to create a buffer. Right, so you go to scanner here. Syntax of scanner is scanner, and you write the in here, and you write here the new and scanner. Right, so here is a constructor for the scanner class. What you have to pass from where you are reading from, reading the input from system.in. So what it will say that now in this object we have created instance reference variable. So this reference variable is referred to the scanner class, and it is reading from system.in stream. So now you can read that like this, in dot next in. So this you can say that A is holding the integer value which you have entered from the keyboard. So and buffer reader is also same, but you are reading as a buffers of data or buffer of characters. So how it is actually, you required here buffer reader is the public class in a java.io, read, and you write one function, or else you just write input. It will ask that new buffer reader, but here, so you should call here what is that input stream. So buffer, you are reading buffer from which input stream, right? So because of input stream will convert, because of there is a one keyword you are reading from scanner system.in, it will give it as a byte value. You are using the some values input from the system.in, it reads the value as byte value, right? It has to convert into characters. Who is converting into characters? That is, there is a one bridge. That bridge I can say that, so input stream reader, right? Input stream reader is there. That input stream reader reading the character as a byte from system.e. So now this is complete function, right? So buffer reader input new buffer reader of input stream reader of system.in. Now you can read the line or byte input dot read, it will read the one character. If you write read line, right, it will read the one complete continuous sequence of characters until there is an escape characters, one line, right? There are so many characters. This is I would like to give the introduction about the input functions, what I have used, right? And then coming to the output, that is by help of the output stream. And here we are not printing on file or some other streams. So just we are printing on System.out. So system itself is providing that function System.out.print is a one function, the string, and System.out.println with the string, because it will print whatever value you give that, it will print it as a string on string, and it will take the values as a string in your program, and it will print it on screen as a byte value, right? What is the difference between print and println, right? So print will print that without termination, it will print xyz is a string, right? After that cursor will be like here only. If you use println, you go to the print it and terminate the line. That is the difference between. That's what print will print xyz and cursor is remains here, and println will xyz will go to the next line, cursor will go to the next line. That is called as termination line, with termination line, and this without termination. Now whole program I have used only two functions as output, because I am not writing on any file, right? If you need IO operations more details, and you can visit this site, right? You can get the details, because there are so many features to perform the IO operations, right?